Testimony in the murder case of a 2-year-old boy became so emotional today, the judge had to call a recess.
Mollie Shouse is accused of leaving her son in a hot car for 12 hours. WLKY's Ann Bowden watched the situation unfold. She joins us now in the newsroom and here in the studio with the latest, Ann.
Well, Rick and Vicki, Mollie Shouse is accused of getting high at a local apartment while her son, 2-year-old Kenton Brown, sat locked in her car, strapped in a car seat for 12 hours. When photos of that scene were shown, she broke.
Forensic pathology is basically the medico-legal investigation of death.
While the intent behind the death of 2-year-old Kenton Brown at the hands of his mother is key in this case, it's the way he died taking center stage. Chief Medical Examiner Tracy Corey described how she received the little boy's body on a 90-degree day with 3 layers of clothes.
Toy Story themed jacket, a green long sleeve polo shirt, and then underneath that, a yellow onesie.
Corey testified Kenton was in a urine-soaked diaper. Graphic and disturbing photos from the examiner's table illustrated her testimony. Mollie Shouse couldn't contain her emotions.
Kenton had a measured height of 36 inches or 3 feet. He was 3 feet tall. And he had a measured weight of 26 pounds. Now, I plotted those on...
Judge Olu Stevens called a 15-minute recess, but Shouse's sobs increased. Once she was led away and had time to gather herself and return, Judge Stevens came back with a stern warning.
There's no doubt in my mind that your emotions are genuine. Nonetheless, it is necessary for us to get through this trial without interruption.
Corey resumed testimony, presenting evidence of bruising and scars consistent with, in her words, a blunt injury. But the defense countered.
Quite frankly, you have no idea how that bruise was caused, right?
That's correct. Yes, ma'am.
Corey also showed dirt and soil found underneath the child's clothes. She said he was underweight, and the rigor mortis in his body proved he died in the car seat, possibly hours before he was found.
He was in a closed car in a warm environment that his body temperature got so high that he was no longer able to survive.
Now, an interesting part in this case is that the prosecution used the tragedy of Calm Air 5191 in Lexington to demonstrate how extreme heat can actually leave behind significant evidence of the nature and time of death. They also presented more drug evidence against Shouse. The trial is expected to continue tomorrow morning. Ann Bowden, WLKY News.